Hi everyone, Alex here. This video will cover 10 essential JavaScript patterns that can help you write clean, efficient, and maintainable code. Designed patterns are usable solutions to common programming problems, and understanding these patterns can take your JavaScript skills to the next level. So, let's start! The Singleton pattern is useful when only one instance of a class is required across an entire application. This is common for managing global states, configurations, or a single instance of a connection, like a database or API client. Example: imagine an application that needs a single instance of a login service. So each part of the app uses the same logger. The model pattern is ideal for encapsulating the code into independent modules. This is especially useful in applications that have reusable functionality, such as utilities functions, without polluting this global scope. Example: a module for managing user authentications, functions such as login, logout, and get user info. The observer pattern is useful when multiple objects need to be modified or changes to another object state, commonly used in event systems and reactive applications, for example, notifications in real apps. Example: a notification system where multiple UI components are updated when a user receives a new message. The factory pattern is beneficial when creating objects that share common traits, but may vary slightly in property or behaviors. This is common in applications where objects creation is based on specified conditions. Example: a user management system, where different user types, admin, guest, member, have unique properties. Use the prototype pattern when you need to create multiple similar objects from a shared template. In JavaScript, this is beneficial for creating objects instances that share method without redefining them. Example: creating multiple shapes with common patterns, color or border. The decorator pattern is useful for dynamically adding behaviors to objects. It's often used for augmenting objects with additional functionality like login or access control. Adding login capability to an object that performs network requires. Use the common pattern when you need to encapsulate actions as object, allowing for features like undo/random and login of actions commonly used in user interfaces. Implementing undo and redo functionality in the text editor. Strategy pattern used when you have multiple algorithms for a specific task and need to switch between them based on situation, often used for data validation or sorting. Example: a payment processing system that can switch between credit card and PayPal strategies. The proxy pattern is ideal for managing access to an object or adding additional logic before interacting with the object. Common for lazy loading, caching, and access control. Example: adding access control to a sensitive data object. Pretty simple, isn't it? Use the chain of responsibility pattern when there are multiple handlers for requests and it can be passed a long chain until handled. Common in event handling and middleware processing. Example: a request processing pipeline with a validation, login, and execution. As you can see, design patterns are powerful tools that solve common coding challenges and make your applications more robust. By understanding and using these patterns, you can create cleaner, more efficient code that easier to maintain and extend. Try to incorporate these patterns into your project and see how they enhance your coding expertise. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and leave a comment if you found this video helpful. So, see you in the next one.